The National Unit Platform held their much anticipated mobilization rally today in Masaka. However, earlier in the day, as the procession headed to Masaka, a tragic accident happened near St. Lawrence School in Maya. It is reported that one of the commuter taxis in the National Unit Platform convoy collided with another car, Toyota Noah. The drivers of this vehicle ran off, leaving some of the border riders killed. The deceased are Victor Sekanjako, 19 years old, Ismail Seziwa, and Muzafaru, who have been mechanics in Insanji. Those injured were rushed to nearby clinics for urgent medical attention. The deputy police spokesperson of Kampala Metropolitan Local Osjire confirmed the incident and cautioned the NUP supporters to drive with care. He said the hunt for the drivers of the vehicles involved in the accident is still on. Chagulanyi proceeded with his entourage to Masaka. He kept waving for his cheering supporters as he proceeded to the Masaka rally. While nearing Masaka, police diverted the crowds from taking the direction through Masaka town to Masaka Independence Grounds, where NUP had planned to have their rally. They were diverted to Masaka Recreation Grounds, where the mobilization rally took place.
Now, emu namba UFY minankaga mutano y bafiriddewo okunoonyereza kukyagenda maaso naye nga twongera okusaba bannabyabufuzi abeenyigira mu bikolwa bye tuyita processions oba okutambula oba okubeera n'olusegende lw'emmotoka abeeyongezibwako abakuwagizi baabwe bakozese obuvunaanyizibwa nga batambula okwewala obubenje bwo.
Pastoral communities worldwide frequently face hunger and malnutrition challenges, threatening mothers, children, women, and youth. This situation directly undermines Sustainable Development Goal 2 and the urgency of the 2030 agenda, with only 6 years remaining for achieving the SDGs. In Uganda's Karamoja sub-region, the situation is dire. Statistics from the Integrated Food Security Phase Classification Report as of May 2023 shows nearly half, 45%, or 582,000 people are in crisis, and an additional 8%, which is approximately 102,000 people, in emergency. Kabong District is the worst hit, with malnutrition rates as high as 18%. Food security has been worsening since Darius Iluko, team leader of Nakapiri Piti, said that.
So now we have come here also to join the hand to hand with other regions, all the 7 regions here in Uganda, which we have here now. So we are here purposely for that, so that because we are no longer having that brain of but not thinking of saying we have to go for it. No, we have abandoned that. We are now here for peace.
And agriculture is the backbone and pillar of hope. He says that they have started spreading the gospel of discouraging youth from practicing cattle raids and embrace agriculture to address food security in their households. In the past, Karamoja was well known for cattle raids, but now they have joined the rest of the regions in promoting agriculture aimed at fighting famine and poverty among the families. On Thursday, a juror found Donald Trump guilty on all 34 charges of falsifying business records to hide a hush money payment meant to silence porn star Stormy Daniels from publicizing an alleged sexual encounter that he feared would be fatal to his 2016 presidential campaign. Prosecutors successfully laid out a case alleging the hush money and the illegal covering up of the payment was part of a broader crime to prevent voters from knowing about Trump's behavior just as he was about to face Hillary Clinton. Trump, who called the trial rigged, faces a potential sentence of 4 years in prison but is much more likely to receive probation. Although the legal earthquake does not prevent Trump from continuing his battle to unseat President Joe Biden and return to the White House, it does cast the already tense contest into unpredictable waters. Trump wasted no time in fighting from courtroom to campaign mode. "I'm a political prisoner," he announced in an online campaign and immediately after the guilty verdicts landed. Trump's conviction on Thursday is a stunning development in an already unorthodox presidential election with profound implications for the justice system and, perhaps, U.S. democracy itself. But in a deeply divided America, it's unclear whether Trump's conviction will have an impact at all on the 2024 election.